When you first start up MSMAC 3D, you'll notice a video will come up. Let me hit pause on that because it's being in duplex. The first one will walk through my first project. The next and some of the others that are on the playlist will be on various topics, etc. You can hit the playlist here and it'll show you a list, and that list will be changing. I'll probably be creating more today, tomorrow, and the next couple days to show a lot of the options and everything. This is really a general overview of some of the other additional things in addition to my project that are out there. So one of the things I wanted to mention is in the projects menu, the first item that comes up, of course, is my first project, which I cover in a different video, which is actually the first video that will come up when you start up and edit 3D. But I also have out in projects a number of additional items. 2002 SCARS Test 2, 2007 New York Stars, a sample hill climb, and a Toyota pickup roll. Hill climb is just kind of an extension of what was in the My First Project. If we're just going to click go to graphics, you notice it's just a kind of fun with the following these two cars that just go up a hill. We actually allow them to run off a hill. I think we had something similar to this out on the video, YouTube list video, but they both run off, and I kind of pan and zoom using the options. If you want to see what went into making this, you click again the edit elevation, and you see that I just basically put a hill here, and you can go down. If you click edit elevation, you can see what the elevations are. You know, there's 10 foot there. 27 feet, you know, there's different elevations, etc. And then I put in triangles and made that. So that's on that project. We'll probably go into more detail in other videos that I prepare in the next few days. Another item in the project open, we have SCARS 2002. And one of the things that we're adding is, and which will be on all these validation videos, is you notice up here there's a info about this project. And if you click on info about this project, it will bring up actually full screen, but I'm going to make it smaller. Brings a item which includes highlights over here where you can bring in the different specifications, things that were available, some of the measurements, photos, ground level. A lot of them we're going to have analysis of it, just do standard momentum analysis, and I have not put those in yet, but they should be in very shortly. But so that way you know that there's a about this project item. Next item is if we just, you know, click run, you can go to it. You'll see that things run at about 3 times real time. So if you have a 5 second run, it'll take 5 divided by 3 seconds to run. This one is where we're using the snag input and also using the tracking camera. And anytime you can turn off the tracking camera, you hit pause, click here, take off tracking camera, and then you could just go to a standard view. We'll also probably have the videos of these. Some of them are on the web. You'll see we have a validation section on our YouTube page. Another item we have in the projects, new projects. New York Stars. This one, I know we had an analysis, but I have not added. There's no info up here, but that'll be in the, there'll be a detailed analysis on that. Some of you have attended the seminar will have seen that. And again, this is just a simple impact, but it's got the side slap, and part of the analysis is showing the changing of the vectors that, you know, with momentum, you have to pick a single direction that the vehicles go from separation to rest. And this demonstrates why there's some shortcomings in momentum, why you need to test and refine your momentum results. And last but not least, we have a projects Toyota pickup roll. And this is just showing how, if any of you have done rollovers or anything, some of you are very familiar with HVOSM. This is a 13 second, if you notice. And so it's going to take about 5 seconds here to run. And hopefully this, so I guess I don't have the automatic pan on this yet. If But you see, it's showing at two different speeds, and actually, neither of the speeds, or I guess this is the one, one speed's at 78 and the other one's at a different speed. Now, if we wanted to, and I guess I'll just show you right now how we could do tracking camera. It does have tracking camera, but let's go and say previous. Let's bring this in and bring it in closely. We add that, and then we let it run a little bit. Let's just keep it so we keep them in. I'm going to add there. Then in that view, you run it forward a little bit more. And then you can go back in and refine these. This is why this is a quick way to start it. Add that. Add that. And we'll just stay here because this is the end. But now when you hit play, now, if you wanted to come in a little closer, again, the way to do it, you click on here and you say, let's just say we wanted to come down closer and zoom in. We update and we'll go to the next. Update, go to the next. Update, next. And that's the last one. So let's just go ahead and watch that now. You see, we're a little closer. Whole point of this is that when you're trying to reconstruct something, sometimes changing just one variable or whatever, it's nice to be able to turn off interaction of the two vehicles with each other so you can see what the minor changes you do to make on the overall results. So we exit that. And that's a quick 7-minute intro to what we have out there. Thank you for watching.